Hello everyone, welcome back to the course Power Plant Engineering. In the earlier lectures, we have started our discussion with respect to nuclear power plant. In the previous videos, we have discussed on nuclear physics, in which we have discussed many terms related with the nuclear energy and nuclear fuel as well. After that, we have seen two important phenomena are reactions in the nuclear physics, which is nuclear fusion and nuclear fission, by which we will get the energy in the nuclear power plant, which we can convert it into the electrical energy. Now in this lecture, we will discuss on a nuclear reaction. In nuclear physics, a nuclear reaction is the process in which two nucleus or nuclear particles collide to produce products different from initial particles. So earlier we have seen different nuclear reactions. Now in the nuclear physics, a nuclear reaction is a process in which two nucleus or a nuclear particle collide, and after this collision, the product will be are different from the initial particles. In principle, the reaction can involve more than three particles colliding, but because the probability of three or more nucleus to meet at the same time at the same place is much less than for two nucleus, such an event is exceptionally rare. While the transformation is spontaneous in the case of radioactive decay, it is initiated by a particle in case of nuclear reaction. If the particles collide and separate without changing, the process is called elastic collision rather than a reaction. Now let's see one example in which it will be get clear a nuclear reaction. Let's consider 6Li3 and deuterium reacts to form highly excited intermediate nucleus 8Be4, which is then decay immediately into two alpha particles. Protons are symbolically represented by red spheres and neutrons by the blue spheres. It will be get clear to you in this figure. In this figure, these blue are the neutrons and red are the protons, which contains a positive charge. So in the reaction, we have 6Li3 and 2H1, and the products are 6Li3 plus 2H1, which will produce, or through this nuclear reaction, we will get 4HE2 and 4HE2. In simple language, it is 2-4-HE2. To balance a equation above the second nucleus, to the right must have atomic number 2 and mass number 4. It is therefore a product like a helium 4. The complete equation determined from this nuclear reaction. Let's proceed further. Nuclear power plants operate precisely controlling the rate at which nuclear reactions occur, and that control is maintained through the use of several redundant layers of safety measures. So in a nuclear power plant, the nuclear reaction is a controlled reaction, and for controlling the nuclear reaction or nuclear chain reaction, several measures have been taken care to control the nuclear reaction. Moreover, the materials in a nuclear reactor core and the uranium enrichment level makes a nuclear explosion impossible. Even if all safety measures fail, on the other hand, nuclear weapons are specifically engineered to produce a reaction that is so fast and intense, it cannot be controlled after it has started. So a positive nuclear power plant In nuclear weapons, the reaction is uncontrolled kind of reaction, where once that reaction is going to start, it is just impossible to control that chain reaction or nuclear reaction. When properly designed, this uncontrolled reaction can lead to an explosive energy release. Then, next we will proceed for nuclear chain reaction. So earlier we have seen nuclear reaction. Now, when nuclear reaction is going to produce multiple chain reactions or multiple reactions, so it will be a chain reaction. A nuclear chain reaction occurs when one nuclear reaction causes an average of one or more nuclear reactions, thus leading to a self-propagating number of these reactions. So from one reaction, it will be get multiplied to few more reactions, and from those, it will be get multiplied, and this chain will get continued. The specific nuclear reaction may be the fission of heavy isotopes, for example, uranium-235, or fusion of light isotopes, for example, 2H and 3H. The nuclear chain reaction is unique since it releases several million times more energy per reaction than any chemical reaction. So if we compare energy produced through chemical reaction and energy produced through nuclear reaction, the energy as compared to the energy released, the nuclear chain reaction is unique since it releases several million times more energy per reaction than any chemical reaction. So if we compare any chemical reaction and nuclear reaction, so there will be enormous amount of energy will be produced from the nuclear chain reaction as compared to the chemical reaction. So this is a figure or picture shows a chain reaction. Obviously it is a nuclear chain reaction. So from one uranium-235, we will have two, and from that one, once again, two, and further more number of products, that is nuclear products or nuclear reactions will be get produced, and it will continue to produce the enormous amount of energy. If we compare fusion and fission processes, which are most important reactions in the rather nuclear reactions in the nuclear physics. So if we compare fusion and fission, light element fuse together with release of energy. In case of fusion, in case of fission, energy is released by the bombardment of heavy nuclear with the neutrons. The nucleus splits into fragments of equal mass. In case of fusion, heavy mass will be converted into energy, whereas in case of fission, light mass will be converted into energy. In case of fusion, the amount of radioactive material consumed is very low, whereas in case of fission, it is very high. As far as fusion is concerned, health hazard is very less, and in case of fission, it will be very dangerous for the health, as well as it will be dangerous to control as well. In case of fusion, construction of controlled fusion reactors is very difficult, whereas it is possible to construct self-sustained fission reactors and have positive energy release. In case of fission, very, very high temperature is required for the fusion process. In case of fission, manageable temperatures can be obtained. Let's move further for fission chain reaction. So we will take an example in this. So fission chain reaction occurs because of interactions between neutrons and fissile isotopes such as uranium-235. The chain reaction requires both the release of neutrons from the fissile isotopes undergoing nuclear fission and the subsequent absorption of some of the neutrons in fissile isotopes. When an atom undergoes nuclear fission, a new neutron, the exact number depends on the several factors, are ejected from the reaction. These free electrons will then interact with the surrounding medium, and if more fissile fuel is present, some may be absorbed and cause more fission. Thus, the cycle repeats, gives a reaction that is self-sustaining. A possible nuclear fission chain reactions are, first, a uranium-235 atom absorb a neutron and fission into two new atoms, which are the fission fragments, releasing three new neutrons and large amount of binding energy. In the second, one of those neutrons is absorbed by the atom of uranium-238 and does not continue the reaction. Another neutron leaves the system without being absorbed. However, the neutron does collide with an amount of uranium-235, which then fission and releases two neutrons and more binding energy. In the third, both of these neutrons collide with uranium-235 atom, each of which fission and releases a new neutron, which can then continue the reaction. Let's see fission chain reaction. In more generalized sense, a nuclear fusion reaction can be considered a nuclear chain reaction. It occurs under the extreme pressure and temperature conditions, which are maintained by the energy released in the fusion process. In this, let's see critical mass. Although 2 to 3 neutrons are produced for every fission, not all these neutrons are available for continuing the fission reaction. If conditions are such that the neutrons are lost at the faster rate than they are formed by the fission, the chain reaction will not be self-sustaining in case of fusion nuclear reaction. At the point where the chain reaction can become self-sustaining, this is referred as a critical mass of the atomic material. In an atomic bomb, a mass of fissile material greater than a critical mass must be assembled instantaneously and held together for about a millionth of a second to permit the chain reaction to propagate before the bomb explodes. The amount of fissionable materials critical mass depends on several factors such as shape of the material, its composition and density, and the level of purity. A sphere has a minimum possible surface area for a given mass and hence minimizes the leakage of neutrons. By surrounding the fissionable materials which are suitable neutrons, reflector, the loss of neutrons can be reduced and the critical mass can be reduced. Let's see what type of nuclear materials which has been used in case of nuclear power plant for the energy production. Special nuclear materials consist of uranium-233 or uranium-235, which is enriched uranium or plutonium. Source material is a neutral uranium or thorium or depleted uranium that is not suitable for use as a reactor fuel. Byproduct material in general is a nuclear material other than special nuclear material that is produced or made radioactive in a nuclear reactor. Byproduct material also includes the tailing, that waste produced by the extracting or concentrating uranium or thorium from an ore produced primarily for its source material content. Nuclear fission fuels are classified as fertile or fissile by behavior on their nucleus in the fission reaction. Let's see about the fissile material and fertile material. In the fissile material, these are composed of atoms that can be split by neutrons in a self-sustaining chain reaction to release enormous amount of energy. In nuclear reactors, the fission process is controlled and the energy is harnessed to produce electricity. In nuclear weapons, the fission energy is released all at once to produce a violent explosion. The most important fissile material for nuclear energy and nuclear weapon are an isotope of plutonium-239 and an isotope of uranium-235. Uranium-235 occurs in the nature. About the fertile material, these are not itself fissile, that is fissionable by normal neutrons, that can be converted into a fissile material by irradiation in a reactor. There are two basic fertile materials. One is uranium-238 and thorium-232. When these fertile materials captures neutrons, they are converted into fissile plutonium-239 and uranium-233. This is details about a nuclear material and its type. So in the most of the nuclear reactors or nuclear power plant, the uranium, thorium and plutonium, these nuclear materials have been used, which are enriched by some systematic process. Let's move further to the nuclear power reactors, where the nuclear energy is released by the nuclear reactions or nuclear chain reactions, and that is when absorbed by the coolant, which will be transferred or utilized to convert water into the steam. Nuclear reactor produces and controls the release of energy from spitting the atoms of elements such as uranium, plutonium. In nuclear power reactor, the energy released from continuous fission of the atom in the fuel as heat is used to make the steam. The steam is used to drive turbines, which will produce the electricity. This is applicable to most of the fossil fuel plants. Earlier, we have seen it in case of thermal power plant as well. As far as fuel is concerned, usually pellets of uranium oxide, UO2, are arranged in tubes to form fuel rods. The rods are arranged into fuel assemblies in the reactor core. So uranium oxide, pellets of uranium oxide has been used as a fuel in the nuclear power reactors. As far as motor is concerned, it will control or slow down the release of neutrons from the fission so that they can cause more fission. It is usually a water, but maybe heavy water or graphite as well. This is the pictorial view of nuclear power plant. in which this is the containment structure of the reactor, where we can see with the help of nuclear fuel, the energy is produced in this chamber or nuclear reactor. This released energy from the nuclear fuel or nuclear chain reaction is being transferred to the steam generator with the help of coolant. So heat energy released in the reactor is being absorbed by the coolant, and the heat energy absorbed by the coolant is then absorbed by the water, or it will be helpful to generate steam from the water. This produced high pressurized steam is utilized to drive the turbines, and once it has been used by the turbine to drive, then after it will be once again condensated with the help of cooling towers, and once again that heat is been recovered to produce a heat to produce the steam once again in the steam generator. So this is overall working structure of the nuclear power plant. In this, one more important component is a control rods. You can see it very clear in the picture below. The control rods are made with the neutron absorbing material such as cadmium, hafnium or boron, and are inserted or withdrawn from the core to control the rate of reaction or to halt it. That is, secondary shutdown system involves adding other neutron absorbers, usually in the primary cooling system. So with the help of control rods, the neutrons are absorbed, and once the neutrons has been absorbed, the nuclear chain reaction can be into the control form. So therefore, control rods plays a significant role or vital role in the nuclear reactor. For this control rod, cadmium, hafnium or boron is most preferred material, because these are the neutron absorbing material. Therefore, it has been used in the control rods. So this is an image of the nuclear reactor, where you can see moderator. This is fuel element channel inside which the fuels are placed. Then graphite moderator, which will slow down the process, and the control rod, which will absorb the neutrons. So this is hot gases, and this inside assembly is the reactor core. Here we can have the heat exchanger, which will transfer or exchange the heat from the nuclear reaction to the steam generator. So this is about the nuclear reactor. Then about the coolant, a liquid gas, liquid or gas circulating through the core so as to transfer the heat from it. In light water reactors, the moderator functions also as a coolant. So in case of nuclear power plant, the energy produced in the nuclear reactor or core of the nuclear reactor is been absorbed or transferred with the help of coolant. For example, in case of light water reactors, it is a kind of a reactor or type of the reactor in which moderator functions also as a coolant. Then pressure vessel or pressure tubes, usually a robust steel vessel containing the reactor core and moderator or coolant, but it may be a series of tubes holding the fuel and conveying the coolant through the moderator. And the most important is the steam generator, which will rotate the alternator's rotor which will generate the electrical energy. And the rotor of the steam generator, as it is mechanically coupled with the turbine and which will be driven by the steam, it will get rotate and produce the electrical energy. About the classification of the reactors, many criteria have been referred to classify the different nuclear reactors. So first, the classification is based on the neutron energy. In this, we have the fast reactor and the thermal reactor. In case of fast reactor, fission is effected by fast neutrons without use of the moderators. And in case of thermal reactors, fission is effected by fast neutrons are slowed down with the use of moderators. So first is referred without moderator and second is without the moderator. The slow neutrons are absorbed by the fissionable fuel and chain reaction is maintained throughout the cycle. Then on the basis of a fuel used, so first is a natural fuel and second is enriched uranium. In the natural fuel, natural uranium is used as a fuel and generally heavy water or graphite is used as a moderator. So wherever natural fuel, the fuel which is available in nature, if it has been used directly, for example, a natural uranium, so heavy water or graphite is used as a moderator in that type of reactor. In case of enriched uranium, the uranium used contains 5 to 10% of uranium-235 and ordinary water can be used as a moderator. So depending on the type of fuel, we have two types of nuclear reactors. One is a natural fuel and other is the enriched uranium. Third type of classification is based on the moderators used. So depending on the moderator, we can categorize or classify the reactors. So first is water moderator, where water is used as a moderator fuel. Then heavy water moderated, then graphite and barium. In the next, basis of classification is coolant used. So in some reactors, water is used as a coolant. Then gas is also used as a coolant. Then liquid metal and organic liquids. So these are also used as a coolant. The main function or main use of the coolant is the transfer the heat or exchange the heat from the nuclear reactor to the steam generator. Depending on the use of reactor, so first is electricity nuclear power plant, then propulsion, nuclear marine propulsion, and second is various proposed form of the rocket propulsion. Then other use of heat, in which dissemination, heat for domestic and industrial heating, and hydrogen production for the use of hydrogen economy. So these are very rare type of available energy conversion methodologies or methods, that is domestic and industrial heating. Very rarely the nuclear fuel is used as a source of energy. Then depending on the production reactors for the transmission of elements, then in this breeder reactor, a fast breeder reactor are capable of producing more fissile materials than they consume during the fission chain reaction by converting fertile uranium-238 or plutonium-239, which allows an operational fast reactor to generate more fissile material than it consumes. Thus, a breeder reactor once running can be refueled with the natural or even depleted uranium. Then creating a various radioactive isotopes such as americium for use in smoke detectors and cobalt-60 then molybdenum 99 and others used for imaging and medical treatment. Production of materials for nuclear weapons such as weapon grade and plutonium. So these are graphical representation of different types of reactors. In the next lecture, we will see all these reactors in detail. Thank you.